Hey everyone, this is Dr. Walker. This is video 255. It's called right hand rule number 2. Let's take a look at this right hand rule. The purpose of this rule is to find the direction of the magnetic field due to a straight current carrying wire. We just learned in a previous video that a moving charge in a wire, which is a current, is going to produce a magnetic field. Right hand rule number 2 is easier than the first one. All you do is you point your thumb in the direction of the current, and then your fingers curl in the direction of the magnetic field. So use your right hand, and your thumb is up. That means the current is going that direction, and then your fingers are curling this way. So what is important to see is maybe look at this a little bit from above. Look at your fingers from above and see which way that your fingers are curling. If you're looking at it from above, you would see that they're curling counterclockwise. You make a circle in the direction that you see your fingers here. They're going towards you and then they're looping around this way. You make a circle in the direction that your fingers are looping. So in this case, it would be a counterclockwise direction for the magnetic field due to a current going upward. Let's take a look at 3 different questions. The first one says, compared to the magnetic field at point A, the magnetic field at point B is in which direction? So the current is straight up. If we use the right-hand rule, then we just said that the field is going to go counterclockwise as viewed from above. But what we have to do now is put this wire kind of in front of us. Let's see if I can put it this way. And which way is the field going at different locations? So A is to the left of the wire. So this is the left for me. Remember, this is a mirror image for you. So at point A, which way is the magnetic field going? Well, it really helps to do the circle with your other hand. If it's going counterclockwise, then at point A, you can see that it's going out into the page, right? It's going away from you. Again, you make this circle here and you stop here and you see, okay, it was going that way, which for me, again, the page is right here, means it's going into the page. And then as you keep looping around, as you get to point B on this side, you're coming towards yourself. So that means at point B, it's going out of the page, right? So counterclockwise loop as viewed from above, it's going into the page on the left of the wire, and it's coming out of the page on the right of the wire. So the way that you would notate this is anywhere on the left of the wire, you would put an X for the field going into the page. Anywhere on the right-hand side of the wire, you would put a dot for the field going out of the page. So the magnetic field is going in an opposite direction, but what's really important, a takeaway message from this problem, is to really understand which way the field is going based on how your fingers are curling. Let's look at another problem. Number 2, it says, which way is the current going? So we have a wire here that is going into and out of the screen. And we want to know, is the current going into and out of the screen based on the direction of the compass needles? So this is a 2-step process. First, which way is the magnetic field based on the compass needles? Secondly, use your right hand rule and have your fingers loop in the direction of the magnetic field and then see which way your thumb is going, because your thumb is the direction of the current. So go ahead and try it out on your own, pause the video, and now let's go ahead and take a look at it. The red arrow is the north pole of that compass needle, and that is the direction of the magnetic field. So the magnetic field is going counterclockwise, right? Because we defined the direction of the magnetic field as the direction that the north compass of that compass needle points. Okay, so now it means that we want the magnetic field our fingers to curl counterclockwise, which way does the thumb have to be for this to happen? So if you put your hand in front of you with your thumb facing you, if you do that, right hand of course, then you see that if you use your left hand to see that your fingers are curling counterclockwise. Just loop your fingers in the direction that your fingertips are pointing. You'll have a counterclockwise. This is counterclockwise. All right. So that's what we wanted. We wanted the fingers to loop counterclockwise. And for that to happen, the thumb had to point towards us, which means out of the page. So that means that the current is going out of the page. And that produces a magnetic field counterclockwise. And getting the hang of this? Let's try one more problem. It says point P is above the wire as you look straight down at it. In which direction is the magnetic field at P? So pretend that this wire is on a table and you're just looking above, from above, you're just looking down at this wire. And the current is pointing to the right. This is the current. And we want to know which way is the magnetic field going. So try it out on your own. Use the right hand rule and see what you can figure out. What's really tricky here is to really understand the location, right? The location that we care is directly above the wire, not here or not down here, but above the wire if we're viewing it from the top. So, right hand rule number one says point your thumb. Not much room here with the microphone taking up all this room. And the camera's over there. So there we go. Point the current to the right and look at which way that your fingers are looping. Your fingers are looping this way, which means if you're behind, this is behind the wire, they're going up. And then as you go here on top of the wire, the fingers are pointing towards you. As you are right above the wire, because again, I'm looking at this thumb, I'm looking at it from above, you can see the direction of your fingertips is going straight down. And then if you're over here underneath, then the fingers are pointing into the page. So really understand the directions based on the looping of your fingers. So what we're seeing is a loop like this, where it's going in front here and behind. That's the loop of your fingers. That's the magnetic field. So if you're right here above the wire, you can see that the field is going downward. If it was asking for a point right here, what would it be? It would be into the page. And then up here, it will be out of the page. Right, so anywhere up here, the field is out of the page. Anywhere down here, the field is into the page. But right here, right in front of the wire, the field is actually going down. So you'll get plenty of practice with right hand rule number two. The key is to definitely use the right hand. And one more thing to help you remember, because you're going to learn another rule pretty soon. Your thumb can only go straight if it's not, too curved. Pretend your thumb is completely straight. With that in mind, your thumb has to represent something that is straight. So in this case, if we have a straight wire carrying a current, the thumb must be the straight wire. And then that means that your fingers are going to loop around for the magnetic field. So just remember, if your thumb is straight, that means it must represent something that is going straight. If you have a current in a straight wire, the thumb must be the direction of that current. Keep that in mind so that it will help you once we get to the third rule coming up very soon.